Hello people, Nilofer here from Me with a Pencil. This video is my take on a sunrise on a cloudy mountain. So let's paint. I have taped my paper, a Bohong 100% cotton paper with the masking tape on. I'm using a pad, so I've taped it all four corners. I'm using a fresh water in the jar. For extra use, I always like to remove some extra water on the side or a little cup. For brushes, I'm using two mop brushes, one a thicker one and one a small size mop brush. Second, I'm using a cypress mop brush. It's a synthetic brush and my Winsor Newton 3-number brush. Let's begin. For colors, I am using a cinereal yellow, like Naple yellow, Indian yellow, and cinereal and Winsor Newton reds with also Winsor Newton Paynes gray. A mix, yeah, and also a Winsor Newton magenta. To start off, yes, also very essential, a paper towel. To start, we will wet the whole canvas. I'm using a fat mop brush. It gives me a good coverage when I'm wetting my whole canvas. Make sure it's wet from all four corners. You can remove the excess water if it should not be a puddle on the sides or on the top of the paper. Now let's start putting more colors. To reactivate, I am gonna spray some color. Spray some water using my spray bottle. It helps to reactivate the color quick and easily. I'm using an Indian yellow and swiping it from left to right and mixing it. I'm gonna be mixing color directly on the paper. So I've used Indian yellow and then mixed with a bright red, like any primary red you can use in this case. This creates a nice dawn morning sky. You want a nice morning sky to get that nice cloudy morning sunrise. Now, for the next layer, I have mixed my red, the bright red, with Paynes gray, which creates a little bit of maroonish color where you can create a nice drama in the sky. A little bit of strokes from left to right, just leaving the middle spot. Now we're going to be making a sun. Since you have to make it quickly, use the top of any circular object. So I am using my gouache, the top of my gouache cube. Just wrap it up with a tissue paper. You can use a coin, you can use any small circular object and use it like a stamp. Hold it over there. This clean circle will only come, you'll only get it when your paper is quite wet. If your paper has dried and if you try to do this picking up with the cotton, with the tissue paper, you won't get a nice white circle. So you have to make sure that you have to act quickly after adding your background. Now I'm adding the same dark color from that goes through the sun and a little bit on the top. Again, using some Indian yellow to create a nice bright look in the below the sun that reaches all the way down to the mountain. If you feel that you want to add more color at any point, at any spot, mix some colors and make it darker. So remember, this is a layer to layer painting, So once the painting dries, we again add some layers wherever we feel that it's become lighter. So here you see I've added another dark layer below where the orange, where the yellow ends. Now this is where the mountains meet the sky. So, and I'm creating some orangish shadow, where it's quite bright in the sky, adding some lines to give you a nice cloud effect. Now I'm adding some dark, direct Paynes grey on the sides of my sun to give a little, that helps the sun to pop out more and give you a little drama in the sky with the clouds. I'm switching it to my smaller mop brush and picking up some extra colors that on the side. And so when you are painting, mop brushes are the really good option, really good to paint landscapes especially. I post new video content every Monday and Friday on watercolours. I hope you guys have subscribed to our channel and do not miss out any of our tutorials. Do like and subscribe and leave some comments if you have, like if you've tried this painting or any other painting from our channel. It will really help us grow and we would love to hear from you. Which mop brush do you use? I use a Raphael mop brush and an Art Essential mop brush, which is available in India. This Art Essential mop brush is also a Kazan squirrel synthetic synthetic mop brush. It's quite similar to the natural hair mop brush. Yes, the feel is different, but it's quite good. Have you tried it? So do let me know in the comments below. So coming back to the painting, now I am creating some mountains, a layered mountain effect. So here we do not want to create a silhouette of a mountain, so we're gonna just run through lines of the mountain and keep blending the below part, like creating a misty mountains or mystery trees, pine trees, I think, if you've tried that. So this is quite similar to those mountains and trees. You create those lines and then quickly blend the excess of colors. So that gives you an effect of clouds and mountains at the same time. Some kind of little fast forwarding the video as it's quite long. So to paint these mountains, you don't have to worry about the shapes. It's okay if the shape is not perfect of the mountain. And remember what you would be doing for the first layer, second, third, fourth. There are going to be like at least 4-5 layers of mountain. Hence it would look like there are multiple layers of mountain and then the sun is rising. So do not worry like what shape it should be or what should I paint. Just go along with your instincts and paint exactly the same shape, just keeping a finger space or something, like a very tiny space between the mountains where you allow the clouds to float around. Now once you finish and remember the end where your painting is ending, the below mountain is going to be a full mountain. There we do not want any cloud space. We are going to silhouette the whole thing with a brown or a gray color. Once you've finished doing one layer of your mountain, go back again and try to vary with light-handed, no pressure at all. Remember, when you're doing such delicate strokes, do not add any pressure to your brushes or with your colors. With a very delicate stroke, just go over it again and create more strokes, create more mountains to the edges. Some of the mountain lines would not be so prominent. The others would be very light, would be very prominent. So you play around with it till you get your play around and have fun with it till you get what you're looking for. So you see, I was not quite convinced or not very happy with that below mountain. So I went over it again and connected it to try more, stretched it a little bit above. So you can do that too. Try to create a thin little layers, thin little small layers of mountains. Once you've done that, let it dry. Let's come back to our sky and add some colors. Now you see, after drying, it's become a little light, the sky has become a little lighter. We'll throw in some little bit more of color. I'm using a Bohong Academy level, that is a student level watercolor paper. I prefer if you could use 100% cotton paper. The Bohong Academy level paper is also 100% cotton paper. I've put down all the material from my Amazon curated list below in the captions. You can go and purchase all the materials that I use in my videos. Why you should use 100% cotton paper, I will do a supply video soon where I speak about all the supply, the paper, the color, the brushes. I hope you are looking for it. Are you looking for something like that where I speak about the supply, and would that be helpful for you? Please do let me know in the comments. So why you should use a 100% cotton paper? Reason that you get a nice blending. You get a lot of area to play around, to work around with it, and you can pick up a lot of color. So do like where I just picked up so much color, wherever I've put excessive color, I just take some tissue paper and I pick it up. If you do that similar thing on a cotton paper, on a 25% cotton paper or non-100% cotton paper, you won't get that similar effect. Now, before we remove our masking tapes and end the, I'm just giving a little bit of touch up to my mountains and creating a little let's just call it a cloudy effect to my cloudy effects to my mountain, where I can show that there was a little bit of cloud. You do that by adding a very light layer of gray, a very thin transparent layer of gray that helps you create a nice cloud outline. Then I finishing up with adding more color, a little bit darkening some areas where I want to highlight my mountains. So now let's peel off the masking tape off. And so I like to add a little bit of detail, some missed out details, or some I feel that after the masking tape is off, I can see more clearly my own painting, and I feel like I want to add some more strokes or some more details where I've missed out. So to create a little bit of underlining in my sky where I can show a little more of there are multiple layers of clouds, I've added these bright red stroke, and I'm quickly blending them into the whole painting. So some of the strokes I'm not completely paint blending it into the sky. Some of the strokes I'm blending it. I think it was not necessary. So like here on the top, I've created a stroke which I don't think I want to keep it. So I'm gonna blend it out. Yeah. So now you see, like, these strokes help create a layer of clouds in my mountain when you in my sky. These strokes. So I'm gonna add a couple of more strokes with lighter color, some dark color. Yes, you can do that when you have your masking tape on too. I like to add these kind of details after I remove my masking tape. I know it's quite a little weird. I hope you've enjoyed the whole video, and do let me know in the comments below and subscribe to our channel. And we are also on Instagram. If you try this painting, do tag us or use hashtag me with the pencil to share your work. We would love to see your work and post about it on our page, share about it on our page too. Thank you guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget, on Wednesday we will be posting our first calligraphy video by Magenta Watercolour. So stay tuned and don't forget to tune in on Wednesday. See you on Friday now for another watercolor video. Thank you and bye bye.